Welcome everyone. Wu Lianda, or Wu Lianda, was a Malaysian physician renowned for his work in public health and particularly the Manchurian plague of 1910-1911. Wu was the first medical student of Chinese descent to study at the University of Cambridge. He was also the first Malayan nominated for the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine in 1935. Wu was born in Penang, one of the three towns of the Straits Settlements, the others being Malacca and Singapore. The Straits Settlements formed part of the colonies of the United Kingdom. His father was a new immigrant from Taishan, China, and he worked as a goldsmith. Although his mother's family had originated from China and was of Hakka heritage, she herself was a second-generation Peranakan, born in Malaya. Wu had four brothers and six sisters. His early education was at the Penang Free School. Wu was admitted to Emmanuel College, Cambridge in 1896, after winning the Queen's Scholarship. His undergraduate clinical years were spent at St. Mary's Hospital, London, and he then continued his studies at the Liverpool School of Tropical Medicine, under Sir Ronald Ross, the Pasteur Institute, Halle University, and the Selangor Institute. Wu returned to the Straits Settlement in 1903. Sometime after that, he married Ruth Shukaiung Huang. Wu and his family moved to China in 1907. During his time in China, Wu's wife and two of their three sons died. Wu remarried and had four more children. During the Japanese invasion of Manchuria, in November 1931, Wu was detained and interrogated by the Japanese authorities, under suspicion of being a Chinese spy. In 1937, during the Japanese occupation of much of China, and the retreat of the nationalists, Wu was forced to flee, returning to the settlements to live in Ipoh. His home and collection of ancient Chinese medical books was burned. In 1943, Wu was captured by Malayan left-wing resistance fighters, and held for ransom. Then he nearly was prosecuted by the Japanese for supporting the resistance movement by paying the ransom, but was protected by having treated a Japanese officer. In September 1903, Wu joined the Institute for Medical Research in Kuala Lumpur as the first research student. Wu spent his early medical career researching beriberi and roundworms, Ascaridiidae, before entering private practice, toward the end of 1904, in Kilaya Street, Penang. Wu began work for the Chinese government in 1907 and became vice director of the Army Medical College, based in Tianjin, in 1908. In the winter of 1910, Wu was given instructions from the Foreign Office, Peking, to travel to Harbin to investigate an unknown disease that killed 99.9% of its victims. This was the beginning of the large pneumonic plague pandemic of Manchuria and Mongolia, which ultimately claimed 60,000 victims. Wu was able to conduct a postmortem, usually not accepted in China at the time, on a Japanese woman who had died of the plague. Having ascertained via the autopsy that the plague was spreading by air, Wu developed surgical masks he had seen in use in the West into more substantial masks, with layers of gauze and cotton to filter the air. Gerald Meany, a prominent French doctor, who had come to replace Wu, refused to wear a mask and died days later of the plague. The mask was widely produced, with Wu overseeing the production and distribution of 60,000 masks in a later pandemic, and it featured in many press images. It is believed that the N95 mask is the descendant of Wu's design. Wu initiated a quarantine, arranged for buildings to be disinfected, and the old plague hospital to be burned down and replaced. The measure that Wu is best remembered for was in asking for imperial sanction to cremate plague victims. It was impossible to bury the dead, because the ground was frozen, and the bodies could only be disposed of by soaking them in paraffin and burning them on pyres. Cremation of these infected victims turned out to be the turning point of the epidemic. Days after cremations began, plague began to decline, and within months, it had been eradicated. Wu chaired the International Plague Conference in Mukden, Shenyang, in April 1911, a historic event, attended by scientists from the United States of America, the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Ireland, France, Germany, Italy, Austria-Hungary, the Netherlands, Russia, Mexico, and China. The conference took place over 3 weeks, and featured demonstrations and experiments. Wu later presented a plague research paper at the International Congress of Medicine, London, in August 1911, which was published in The Lancet in the same month. In 1912, Wu became the first director of the Manchurian Plague Service. He was a founder member and first president of the Chinese Medical Association, 1916-1920. In 2020, Dr. Yvonne Ho identified and united the 22 known medical and scientific descendants of Dr. Wu Linda, living in 14 different cities around the world. In May 2020, during the COVID-19 pandemic, she organized the inaugural meeting of these descendants via video conferencing. This was the first time that everyone had had the opportunity to meet everyone else. Thank you all for watching this video. If you like this video, subscribe to Footprints for more videos.